There are various examples of mental harassment that occur at a workplace. It can happen with anyone, irrespective of your designation, your caste, your gender. The various examples, like, you know, any action of your co-worker or your senior that makes you feel bad, makes you feel powerless, or, you know, there's some unwanted demand that your boss is making. There's a term known as quid pro quo, that he's asking for something in exchange for you to do that job. Or, you know, which demeans you, not your work though, but it demeans you. So these are some examples, you know, that occur at a day-to-day, on a day-to-day basis in any workplace. You know, these can be tackled by a lot of, you know, so a lot of due diligence that your redressal committees can do. So basically every company has two committees. One is a redressal committee or an ICC that is formed under your, you know, Sexual Harassment Act. So they have power to, you know, summon the evidences, like they can summon CCTV footage if it's happening at work, if it's happening at, you know, at any common area. Or, you know, your worksheet can be summoned where it shows that, you know, your boss is unnecessarily loading you with work. Or your, you know, there are key eyewitnesses that can be summoned, which can, you know, probably substantiate your story. So these are some examples of work, you know, mental harassment that occurs, and there are various ways to prove them. You can even go to court for that matter.